It's all come down to this. I've talked about Arnandoroids 3 times, their Figmas once, and now it's time to rank all of Good Smile Company's full-scale figures of Hatsune Miku and all the other Vocaloids or whatever other vocal synthesizers there are, as of November 2023, and you know another Miku figure's gonna be up for a pre-order right after this video comes out, but whether they're 1/8 scale, 1/7, 1/4, or whatever, there's no shortage of these figures to go around. Most of them are pretty good, but they still have their flaws, so this huge collection makes for some interesting video material to me. I must set some rules and disclaimers first though. First off, I've made this clear to some people with how I didn't review Kagamihi Iroji's Miku cosplay Nindoroid or Figma, but characters cosplaying as or based on Vocaloids without their names attached don't count, hence why I don't talk about Black Rock Shooter or Lady Rhea, but non-vocal synth characters from media based fully around them, like the Project Sekai characters, are fair game. Secondly, the pop-up parade figures might not entirely count, but they don't have a proper page of their own, plus there's only a handful made of just 2 characters. So I don't see why not to add them here, meaning there's 129 figures of 11 different characters to talk about. Lord help me, but I would like to give a quick honorable mention to Gear Tribe Hatsune Miku GT Project 2014 version from the One Hobby Collection, because if cosplayers and mechas did count, this'd be pretty high up on the list. Who wouldn't want a racing Miku Transformer? You can even make it a car with limbs and that's awesome. Maybe another day I'll properly get to talk about it, but for now it's just about the virtual stars themselves. Let's get this over with already. Alright, before I reveal my least favorite, I want to give an update from my original Nindoroid ranking video. I placed the 2013 Sepang Racing Miku in dead last because I thought it was pointless fan service and that there could have been better ways to celebrate Racing Miku's 10th anniversary. Well, little did I know that making tanned Racing Mikus in bikinis for Sepang or Thailand is actually a bit of a tradition. But that makes the Nindoroid even worse to me, because then why the 2013 version? She must have been the most popular, otherwise the 2017 or 2018 designs would have worked way better, to me. Anyway, I know I'm just one fangirl thousands of miles from Japan, so my opinion on a 4-year-old Nindoroid won't matter to anyone, but that doesn't mean I have to like how many more full-scale figures there are of these types of Mikus. Starting with the Thailand version from 2016, based on the 2014 Racing Miku, just give her a bikini and put her in a chair, and cut her hair a bit too, because it's not like that was one of her most defining details. I just don't like this figure at all. It's okay if you do, but I'd like to move on to the rest of this video, thank you very much. 128, Racing Miku 2010. In all fairness, her initial artwork wasn't all that appealing either, but it makes me all the more grateful that most other Racing Miku figures are vastly superior, because this belongs in a freak show. 127, Racing Miku, Sepang version. Oh look, it's my old friend, now even less covered up. Also, I know it's not the only figure you can do this to, but what's the point of taking her sign away? Is it really that distracting from her skinny little bitch ass? Also that foot is super twisted. Miku, you're gonna trip. What are you doing? 126. Racing Miku 2022, Tropical version. Oh, you thought we were safe enough to escape the Southeast Asian fan service? Think again, fucko, cause this trend's still going, and those shorts almost physically hurt to look at. They don't even look like shorts from the front, just a black bar covering up her junk. I don't like this hood either. If that's what it's supposed to be, it could be a neck pillow for all I know. But if it is a hood, then if it's supposed to shield her from the sunlight, she already has goggles for that. And if it gets cold at night, it does nothing because she's still gonna freeze. And if it's hot all day, why would she even think about pulling it up? I can't stand looking at this thing, but at least the hair's pretty cool, I guess. 125, Miku Hatsune. Yeah, this is one of her first ever figures, and the first one from Max Factory, so its main crime is being old, but we had to start somewhere, right? I'm just glad that the future figures have evolved way past this stiff and sorta rough. Wait a minute, what? Listen, anime-style girls with super short skirts and butt cheek teases are a bit of an industry standard, to put it that way, but Miku's still a minor, and it doesn't make the short skirt any less creepy, nor is this the last time you will see her modeled like this, unfortunately. 124, Kagamine Len, swimsuit version. It couldn't be a video about Japanese figures without the characters in swimsuits. And aren't there only two songs in Project Diva that use them? Why was the series so obsessed with making more? She asked, already knowing the answer. And Len's freakish semi-abs automatically make his figure the worst of the swimsuit set. Please put that chest away, we don't need to see it. 123, Kagamine Rin, swimsuit version. Oh, they made this yellow polka dot bikini real itsy bitsy teeny weeny on purpose. And weirdly enough, not in an even more fanservice-y way than it already is, it's just small. And why are Miku and Luka's torsos normally shaped while Rin's looks almost exactly like Len's? You're embarrassing her enough. 122, Racing Miku, 2016 Thai version. Another one already? Freeing? You shouldn't have. I dunno, she has bracelets and CeVIO hair and cool sandal ribbons. Otherwise it blows, obviously. 121, Megarina Luka, swimsuit version. Yay, more swimsuit figures. But I dunno, it's Luka, the bikini goes with her elegance. Next. 120, Hatsune Miku, swimsuit version. This is the last swimsuit figure, thankfully, but I only put her above Luka because I like her skirt. This bikini's cute enough to work on her, but these figures still suck. 119, Racing Miku 2014, Eevee Mirai version. Ever wanted that one Figma, but with the little fun you could have by moving her joints around sucked out of it? No. Well, too bad, she exists, and with extra tight panties for even more uncomfortable motorcycle riding. I assume, I'm not stupid enough to try it for myself. 118, Hatsune Miku, Tony version. This body's so twisted that I'd break my back if I tried that, or at least sprain my ankle. Also, can you spot why they added an unnecessary cheese that wasn't in the reference picture? I assume Tony was just happy to have a figure based around his art though. 117, 1/7 scale Racing Miku 2012 version. How do you make 2012 Racing Miku ugly? I don't get it. I didn't think it could get worse than the Figma, but it did. At least the Figma's kinda cute, but this face is just so off-putting. She's sorta okay otherwise. I especially like the hair, but the face really drags it down for me, along with the big curves, which definitely aren't the worst, but I still kinda hate that they did this at all to her. 116, Hatsune Miku, Kentaro Ibuki Exosoba version. I'm simply not a fan. The face and hair, whatever. The base making her pop out of a phone is an okay enough idea, but the main problem is of course the outfit. A discount sweet devil design at best and overbearingly shiny and gross at worst. And I know, I should be used to the sexualization already, but this is the only Miku I've seen with a metal heart hole over her bit. So what else do you expect me to say? 115, Racing Miku, 2021 version. She's still disappointing. What else do you want from me? I've complained enough about her and I don't want to look at her again. 114, Racing Miku 2015, Thailand version. I'm already running out of things to say about these things, but this hair is also nice, and at least the 2015 outfit makes for a better bikini than the Sepang and Thailand figures below it. 113, Racing Miku 2010 version, art by Kentaro Yabuki.
Dear artists of Japan, I challenge you to please not make everything so horny for even a second, especially with teenagers.
And this is about Miku's is, not whatever adult characters are portrayed by or based on her, but I did expect worse, so I can't say it's the most uncomfortable of her figures, or it'd be in last place. 112, Hatsune Miku, Family Mart version. Did you miss how lame this type of merch is? I can at least somewhat get behind the Family Mart Nendoroids because they're like tiny little trinkets, but the Happy Lots campaign must have been so special that it needed a whole 1/8 scale figure. 111, Hatsune Miku. This time from the main Good Smile Factory people, and I assume what the Family Mart figure was based on, but I think she's held up pretty well. She's smooth, shiny, and the style is exactly what comes to mind when I think of Miku's early days. Not much else to say other than, like her first Nendoroid, she was a valuable stepping stone towards today's Miku figures. 110, Miku Hatsune, commercial version. It's another default Miku figure, sorta. The website says it's based on the first morning commercial, but I couldn't find anything about whatever that is. So I'll just say that she looks pretty good all things considered. I bet she's really enjoying the music she's listening to. And she has a snow Miku stand. Okay. 109, Racing Miku 2011 version. I've said pretty much everything I've wanted to about her already, but given how well designed and detailed the outfit and flying pigtail strands are, I'd say this is the best version of her if the rest of the hair wasn't so clunky, and the umbrella wasn't stripped of its identity and left a boring shell, and that face fit a little better. Is she okay? Is she gonna cry? 108. 1/8 scale Racing Miku 2012 version. It's definitely nicer than the 1/7 version. The face better fits the body, and I like how she's painted. It gives a somewhat dull but not miserable or unsettling vibe. It's actually an alright fit. But Jesus, the Nindoroid still leagues ahead of the rest of her figures. 107, Kagamine Len, Tony version. Since Tony gave Rin and Len sort of realistic hair, Good Smile interpreted it as make them look like those Dolphy Dream Creepers. I have no idea why Tony's figures either look like regular anime-style figures, uncanny dolls, or a bit of both, but more on the former side. As unsure as I am about these two, I'm a bit more confident in saying that Len's hair could use a little trimming. 106, Kagamine Rin, Tony version. She ranks just a teeny bit higher than Len because she's still kinda cute and I like her pose better. I should probably also mention that she and Len are the only Tony figures that come with a tapestry if the art they're based on for some reason. Same with these piano stands, but I like them. 105, please don't kill me for this, but Megarine Aluka V4X. Now let me be very clear that this is not because she's a bad figure. I think it's pretty well made. I just never understood this Luca design. Okay. Every time I look at it, my brain can't properly grasp what the hell I'm looking at. And it's been that way since the upgrade first came out. I wouldn't mind a big departure from her original design, as iconic as it is, but all these clothes clash against each other and her spaghetti hair so much that it hurts. Except maybe the cyber keyboard arm things, I like those. But it's no wonder Krypton still uses her V2 design more often. Yeah, the rest of the character vocal series too, but shut up. 104, Hatsune Miku, Orange Blossom version. This is something you'll notice with most of the figures based on Project Diva. If they're meant to be based on FSEC and specifically and sculpted by Grizzly Panda, they'll have this weird glossy shine that's really distracting. And it sure doesn't help that I'm already not a fan of Orange Blossom Miku. The color contrast is one thing, but I'm mostly bummed that this is supposed to be the module for Decorator, the main theme of the game with a really galactic rainbowy PV and opening cutscene. This doesn't look like it should go with the song at all. I would say the song deserved a cooler module, but honestly, V2 Miku works fine enough like the other default cryptoids, so what gives? 103, Pop-Up Parade Kanade Yoisuki, the only Project Sekai character in this lineup so far, and the worst of the pop-up parades, cause she's just standing there. There's nothing inherently wrong with it, but it's nothing special. Also, can someone who knows this game better than me explain why Kanade's the main focus of the Nightcurd group, when everything I've seen narratively points to it being Mafuyu? Is it because Kanade does the music while Mafuyu does the lyrics, or that she looks more like Miku? Cause either would be dumb, but it could be worse. At least this isn't a chica. 102, Racing Miku 2020 version. Might be strange not seeing her any lower, but she's grown on me like the 2018 Racing Miku has. Not nearly as much, of course, but her 1/8 scale figure is okay. The hair paint is still the best part, but the eyes go really well with them here. Also, did you know that there was a limited edition version of her Nindoroid that came with a mask? Because I had no idea till now. 101, Hatsune Miku, Symphony 2017 version. I think out of all the Miku figures based on K's art, this one looks pulled directly from his style the most, especially the face. It's just so him. Otherwise, it's not that memorable, even for the first Symphony Miku. It's just her usual outfit made into a dress with bows, and I like the violin, but it's still pretty meh overall. 100, Hatsune Miku Type 2020. Remember this module from Project Diva? It's one of those crossovers from one of the lesser known Sega properties, in this case 7th Dragon 2020. I always thought it was nice, but this figure gave me a new appreciation for the module with its pretty unique sculpting style. The face is a little too freaky looking for me, but it's a small price to pay for a more interesting take on the Miku figure, I guess. 99, Hatsune Miku, Tell Your World Version. Oh, how I wish this could have been the linkage module instead. But no, it's the official design that I don't hate, but never liked all that much. That doesn't mean I think this is a bad figure though, quite the opposite. Maybe a little too detailed in some parts, but the outfit's quite alright. There's only one reason she isn't any lower though, and that's the twin tails. I'd say it's the one advantage of using this design instead of the linkage one, because the way these strands fly everywhere is just crazy. Two of them even wrap around her leg. So sure, that makes the figure worth existing. 98, Pop-Up Parade Hatsune Miku. It sure is another Miku, but this time on her tippy toes, and the knee button things are gone. In fact, most of the black clothes look like melting leather. Very weird against the shiniest shirt of all her V2 figures. 97, Hatsune Miku, Lap Type Version. I bet this Miku design looks familiar to at least some of you. She started out as a popular MMD model and got this cute little 1/8 scale PVC figure in 2011. And making cryptoid models or fan art without the sleeve things is weirdly common sometimes, but this model changes up a bit more about Miku, like the checkered skirt band, headphones, and red ribbon and glasses. But the latter can be taken off if you want. I prefer her with them though, because the lap type feels a bit like a slightly younger Miku still training to get ready for her big debut. And she kinda reminds me of Hamura Akimi, before Yeah. 96, Hatsune Miku, Lat Type Autumn Version. Pretty much the same but with cool fall colors. I especially like the stand green or hair and boot patterns. 95, Pop-Up Parade Racing Miku 2010 Version. Delicious. Finally some good fucking 2010 Racing Miku. I assume to make up for the first one. And it's perfectly fine. It's just her posing like Princess Peach, and that'll do. 94, Pop-Up Parade Hatsune Miku, Because You're Here Version L. This Miku comes from a Pinocchio P song. You can tell by the eyes and eye pin on her tie. But aside from the style and how cool she's painted, that's about as interesting as it gets. She may be desperate for a higher spot, but not even her song being about a sentient Miku figure, I think, can save her. But I guess that makes its existence pretty poetic. 93, Hatsune Miku, HSB version. Now that we've pretty much rounded up the default Miku figures, I'll take any form of originality from them. So here's a cute little take on her from Hannah Salmon P's videos. It kinda reminds me of Kaon with a bit of Lucky Star mixed in, and a cuter plug into this thing. 92, Hatsune Miku, Symphony 2019 version. Yeah, I don't care much for this Miku, and she would have been placed lower, but it gets something right that a lot of her other figures do. Flowing nicely, and I really like the extra transparency in the ends of her pigtails. 91, Tenidal Neo Tokyo Series Idol. Believe me when I say that I only found out that the Tenidal Mikus exist because they're in the related products part of the Panda Bun Figures page and nowhere else on the website from what I remember. And I was already weeks into typing the script changing some of the placements around, so this is exactly what I needed. So I don't care, I'm talking about them here and now. Starting with this Idol Miku, I really like the uniform and the hair, and that's really all there's, she's just nice. 90, Racing Miku 2017 Thailand version. It finally happened. We got a good Thailand figure, and don't go accusing me of being biased, because I swear I'm not. She isn't even my favorite Thailand Racing Miku, even if I stand by my fairy supremacy beliefs and all that. But the flowing twisty hair, dressy midpiece, if that's what you call it, and especially the wings did it for me. They're actually real fairy wings, how do I say no to that? Tony and good smile, you sons of bitches, it took you long enough but you actually made this trend work for a while. 89, Hatsune Miku, Chokobuki Kuru Wakotoba Awas Kagami version, which means
Chokobuki Guo words matching mirror.
All you need to know is that it's from an Akaniko concert, and it's an absolute mess, but a pretty mess. And I really hope I didn't accidentally insult some ancient Japanese tradition by saying this dress is bulky and visually noisy. These designs are amazing though, I'll admit that. But for the life of me, I can't tell if the pink part with the butterflies and flowers is actually part of the outfit or tied onto it. I can't stand to look at her, but I want her. It's weird. 88, Racing Miku 2019, Thailand version AQ. I can see it is just a fun beach figure with cute daisies and heart headphones. Or maybe I just like the Sailor School Girl bikini. I don't know. 87, Racing Miku 2018 Thailand version. Even if this isn't saying much, she's the best Miku from the Sepan and Thailand lineup. I didn't think 2018 of all Racing Miku outfits would make the best swimwear, but it did. Good for her. 86, Lily from Animove. Gotta make sure they point that out every time. And right away the hair isn't as nice as the Nindoroids, but I still like it. Also, I can't be the only one who thinks her boxer pose hasn't been translated to 3D that well, right? I'm still happy she got a figure out all though. 85, Vocaloid Megpoid Mamamashikigumi from Megpoid Whisper version 1.1. Wow, what a title. But jumping right into Intern Echo's only other good smile figure, we have Gumi V3 Whisper, which looks exactly the same as her adult voice bank, but with shorter boots, and I like her V3 designs in spite of how stupid a lot of these changes for most of the voice banks are, but I think you can guess what my main problem is. Speaking of Gumi though, look at how cute her V6 art is. I love it so much. Why'd it take so long for her to peak visually? 84, Racing Miku 2018, challenging to the top. It's her again, and the more time goes on, the more I can appreciate her despite the weird fluffs all over her still weirding me out. But it's the original art made into not her first scale figure, hence the name, but I think saving this pose for later was a good call, as you'll see later. 83, Racing Miku 2018 Summer Version. There's no cape and less fuzz, that's about it, but fitting for the summer, otherwise she'd be too hot. 82, Eeyore on the Planets version 1.5. It's Ea, how can you not love her? Even if, let's be honest, this figure hasn't aged that well, still a good 3D version of her boxert, but her hair's more pinkish than peachy people. Fear not though, this won't be her only figure to discuss. 81, Racing Miku 2016 version, my beloved, and as much as I prefer seeing her in more dynamic poses, I also like seeing more unique poses and props for Racing Miku figures, so here she's sitting on some tires about to drink some off-brand Red Bull, and what are these things? They're characters made out of handicap weights, all named Wei-chan. My only question is what the writing and arrows on the tires mean. Are they directions for which tire goes where on the car, or is this some other racing thing I don't understand? 80. Hatsune Miku Heart Hunter version. Back to the Grizzly Panda figures, and this time with a module I really like, but that same glossy shine is a little too distracting, and I wish it was done more justice, along with a concerning amount of her ass showing, but this heart with wings she's stepping on is cool. 79, Racing Miku 2013 version. Hey, it's her. You know the pose, you know the look, you might even know how every version of her has the reference illustration on their pages, unlike the other Racing Mikus, and I don't get why, but even if the skimpiness of the leotard is about on the same level as the Figma, she still looks cool. Not much else to say about her that I haven't already. 78, Hatsune Miku, the first dream version, based on her first V4 Chinese album, and I gotta say, it's not the best job at bringing the cover to life, but I can't complain too much, because this figure's still cute and pretty. I always love a good flowy pink Miku, and the yellowish accents in the hair are also a really nice touch. 77, Racing Miku 2013 RD4 Suga Support Version AQ. Who would have thought that putting her in a new pose with a new expression would make such a difference? This is one of the more simple figures that works, either in spite or because of said simplicity, but this is the first time I completely forgot about the boob window underneath her tie, and its placement here doesn't help. 76, Tenet Lumikwai Princess. It's a kawaii cotton candy angel core dream, right up my alley, and maybe what Fairy Miku from Project Voltage could have been more like. Also, that unicorn reminds me of that one brand I can't remember the name of to save my life, but their unicorns looked a lot like this but with open eyes and little wings. If anyone knows what I'm talking about, you're a lifesaver. 75, Hatsune Miku, 10th anniversary version. A huge step up from the Nindoroid. Obviously, you're kinda destined to be when you're based directly on the original art, but it's just plain impressive how colorful and glittery they really made her. And are you sure the tie isn't actually glowing? Because it sure looks like it is. So I hope the lucky bastards who bought her are taking good care of her. Maybe the memorial box too? It depends. 74. Figure Japan, Character Vocal Series 01, Hatsune Miku Edition. Or, you know, you could have just said Sakura Miku, cause that's clearly what this is, and it's not as charming as her Nindoroids or Figma, and I might just be saying that cause of all the things they came with, but at least it's an eye pleaser, and you'd be surprised how easy it is for her own company to screw that up. 73, Hatsune Miku with Salwa, cross-branding, baby. This is the outfit that looks most like something I'd realistically wear, and I assume that's true with most people watching since it can kinda pass for normal street fashion. But the pigtails, dude, they look like tentacles and I kinda love that. She's an absolute trendsetter, and it's very cool, very fresh. 72, Racing Miku 2016, Team UTAU version. I assume this was made to be the more active contrast to her main figure, and the hair is once again the best part here. Look at how it flows, and I don't care if it's a bit messy. I like messy sometimes, as you will see more of later, but screw that helmet. She'll be fine without one. She's not real, she's not getting in any accidents. Unless you draw or edit her getting into one. What am I doing? But the most important things to me are 1. The water bottles have their own bag with the exact same label, and 2. There's no bike. She's just carrying around a wheel with her, and I think that's hysterical. As cool and objectively better it would have been if she had a whole bike. The Figma already does, so it's not a total loss. 71, Hatsune Miku, NT style casual wear version. I'm always glad to see NT Miku get more love. The hair is of course still amazingly done, and my favorite parts other than that are the golden charms and bracelets. What's she holding in her hand though? A ring box, an AirPods case. Not even Rella's art can help me figure it out, if this even matters. Unlike the skirt, which flows nicely, but I don't know how to feel about it being this long, or the shoes being the exact same as the regular NT outfit. 70, Eroxaria on the planets. Check her out. As much as I miss the top that was on top of this top, I love how the post says so much about her character and updated voice bank. But enough about the design as is, let's get the obvious about the figure itself out of the way. The hair's already a big step from the first figures in color, thickness, and how the strands are curved, super cool. So why can't she have more figures? Maybe an Endoroid too, please? 69, Hatsune Miku, Maniki Miku version. So remember when I called this design a bit too much for the tiny buddy in my first Nindoroid video? Truth be told, I was mostly coming up with an excuse for not ranking her higher. Even though I could have just left it with the positives and moved on, this brand new full-scale version of the Maniki design is just what I was looking for. Maybe it really did need a bigger body to be perfectly crowded as it should be, and a nice dynamic pose. Just look at how the bells flow on their giant strings. And I really like how the suitcase with the gold coins and spring onion crammed into it are just falling away from her too. But this time I actually do have a valid complaint against her, and that's the face. It's another case of too young looking to be Miku, even if it's much cuter than the magical snow Miku Figma. The Nindoroid's faces just look a bit better on Maniki Miku, so I guess they're a bit more even than I thought. 68, Hatsune Miku V3. Finally, V3 Miku is only now starting to get more love from Good Smile, even if it's a little too late for that now. But right before her V4X update, we got this figure that captures her upgraded design perfectly, mostly the translucent sleeves and how the pigtails twirl and defy logic to make these curves, or would it be curls? I don't know, I just think it's really cool. And since this was sorta made to go with the Luca V4 figure, this is one of the rare times Miku outsold Luca. 67, Snow Miku. Notice anything about her? Yep, in true OG Snow Miku fashion, Freeing gave the V3 figure a blue and silver coat of paint and extended her left arm out for her to hold a snowflake. But they definitely used the right figure to make a Snow Miku version out of, because she was already super cool, and now there's an extra chromatic and mystical edge to her. But for anyone asking why it took this long to get to the first Snow Miku of the video, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but no, the Snow Mikus don't get full-scale figures every year, just Figmas and Endora. But there will be a few more to talk about here. 66, Racing Miku 2022 version. The bigger she gets, the happier she feels, and the flag gets even longer, but that's not stopping her from stepping into the action. So please, can Racing Miku's be this cool from now on? 2023's had a good track record so far, but she still has a lot to live up to. 65, Hatsune Miku, Blue Archive version. This design comes from a game of the same name, another RPG app I know nothing about, but the outfit's a lot better than the Persona 4 collab, so that's nice. I think the beachy sailor aesthetic and the extra effects surrounding the hair tie with the bow are really nice, and that's one hell of a t-shirt cannon. She might not be too outrageous compared to the other Miku figures, but sometimes figures more on the simple side can also be pretty special. 64, Onaria on the planets. I bet this is only because she was made a few years later, but Oni's figure just looks a lot better than the EO she was made to go with. Bold her colors, really shiny metal, and of course the killer eyes and hair. Even with her shy persona, that's how much more appealing they make her. So good for you, Oni, even if your name is so easy and funny to mispronounce. 63, Hatsune Miku, Mebi version. You might think this is some kind of tropical vacation Miku like I did, but no. She's just a ballerina, originally designed by Mebi. I still really like it though, from the crazy rainbow hair to the roses adorning her outfit, contrasted a bit with the cybernetic hair ties and, are those baby wings with exhaust pipes? Well, whatever they are still easier to look at than those feet. 62, Hatsune Miku, Deep Sea Girl version, a song I never listened to until making this video just for the sake of it, which I of course regret not doing sooner. Don't be stubborn like me, but I was of course familiar with her depiction in this song for almost as long as I've been a Vocaloid fan, and I love the approach they went with. Yeah, it's right from the promo art and a lot of song-based figures do that, but look at this base they set up for her. It really looks like they ripped her from right out of the ocean, but she's somehow still there because the current flowing through her shore isn't changing, and I'm especially fond of how they made the coral. 61, Hatsune Miku V4 Chinese, in a freely flowing position take hanok from the box art, but this other drawing by her artist, Mamina Amato. I might prefer the Figma and Nendoroid a teensy bit for their accessories, but this is the V4 Chinese Miku with the best colors and a really neat base. 60, Racing Miku 2019 version featuring Anne and Douthu. We've once again arrived at the most adorable Racing Miku, and she's had two main figures I suppose, but this one came out first, and it's the main pose. There's really not a whole lot to add other than this is the first time I noticed how cool her heels are. This is peak color theory, trust me on this, you don't need to look the definition up. 59, Kagami Nairin, Stylish Energy R version. Of the whole Grizzly Panda Project Diva lineup, the Stylish Energy figures are the least glossy. They can easily pass for any regular Max Factory figures, but I mean that as a good thing because they are pretty neat. I just don't understand why they get figures over the other In and Len modules that actually have songs to go with them, but Bring It On will never get to be in Project Diva, which is a shame because they make me think of that song. 58, Kagami Nairin, Stylish Energy L version. As much as I think the bunny speakers and footwear look better on Rin, Len has the slightly more fitting attitude. Try and guess why else I like his Stylish Energy figure better than Rin's. 57, Hatsune Miku, Happy 16th Birthday version. The 16-year-old is actually 16 this year, or 32 if you want to think about it that way. Maybe that's why Sega got involved with her. But onto the figure with big scrappy wings. I like how they're made up of the things that make Miku, Miku to people, be it the songs, art, stories, or all of those at once. As for the outfit, it's clearly based mostly on her OG design, but am I the only one really off-put by the shirt? The lower frills are just a little too long for my liking. I get the impression that Rella wanted to make a dress, but someone in charge didn't know Miku enough and was too scared it'd make Miku too unrecognizable. But even if that most likely isn't true, the wings are cool, and so is this figure. Just look at this inspiring and thankful face. 56, Hatsune Miku and T. I'm not sure what's more to say about her amazing drip either, so I'll instead focus on how she's presented. This is the warmest and most inviting Miku figure I've ever seen. She just wants to say hi and make you sing with her, and how can you not? But she deserves a better engine. 55, Kagami Nairin Nuclear Fusion. Hell yeah, best Rin song, or I guess remix, but she definitely shows her age. I'd give anything for an update or remaster of this figure, because it was pretty ahead of its time. The stage, the rings around her, that guitar, they already look great, but imagine how they'd look today. But that even more so applies to Rin herself, who'd be at least passable if her face didn't look so smushed. So it hurts me to say this, but she's in the middle of the list for a good reason. Her existing at all is such an amazing power move though, so one day she'll get the rebirth she deserves, right? 54, Racing Miku 2019 version side key visual. Pretty similar to her other main figure, I know, but I like her better blowing a kiss with cartoonish hearts, brighter colors and more swooshy pigtails. 53, Hatsune Miku, My Dear Bunny version. This Project Diva module is meant to go with the song hand in hand, and good god, it's such an odd fit. Why not the star vocalist modules, or ironically enough, Orange Blossom? But I like the module's casino vibes, and the figure is a good job at bringing them to life. 52, Miku Hatsune, cheerful version, based on the winner of Cheerful Japan's illustration contest, and so popular that everyone got cheerful modules like her in Project Diva and Mirai. The idea of a cheerleader Miku jumping over a speaker and turning her upper body around midair sounds like a clumsy disaster of a figure waiting to happen, but I think it was executed really well. What could have been messy or fan service-y instead looks both pretty cool and cute. The proportions, outfit, and style all work pretty well. Why don't I have her in my room right now? And to think, we are not even in the top 50 yet. That's how good a lot of good smiles figures are. It's in the name for fuck's sake. 51. Hatsune Miku, Magical Mirai 2015 version, the first ever Magical Mirai figure from Good Smile, with not the most interesting design, but something still cool enough for her to pull off. I enjoy this figure because of 1. The contrast between the hair starting to go out of control while her pose isn't suggesting there's much else movement going on, and 2. And most importantly, the face. I can only imagine her saying,
"Listen up, you little shits, I've been up since 4 a.m. last night working on all these songs for you. I don't wanna be here either, but you're gonna sit down and enjoy whatever comes out of this show whether you like it or not."
Into the microphone. And now I wish I could have seen the Magical Mirai. 50. Hatsune Miku, Greatest Idol version. This design comes to us from the cover of Michi M's album of the same name, and if you ask me, she's kinda just an upgrade of the first Dream Miku. Why can't all school uniforms look this interesting? Because born people run private education systems. I really like the hair, face, and pose too, but the real star player here is of course, this guitar hybrid. I didn't expect this video to become a list of what would look awesome hanging in my room, but that's what it's become. This is what you people get. I hope you're happy. 49. Raising Miku 2018 version. I know it's weird seeing her this higher up above her other figures, but the main one has the biggest advantage of all, the pose. It's great for a figure, and I'm pretty sure it was made specifically with this in mind. She's just being her quirky royal self, and good for her. Again. 38. Hatsune Miku, Bunny version art by SynthV. Yeah, you know Japan loves their bunny girls, and this'll sound asinine coming from me, but I like how this one's made. It's mostly in the hair and face, and the fishnet tights. But those aside, this feels less sexualized than some of my bottom Miku picks, so maybe my destigmatized feelings help me appreciate her a bit more. I'm not exactly dying to own her, but it's also definitely one of the better bunnies I've seen from Good Smile. Maybe even the best, because it's the only one I know of with a cool half-sleeved leotard and boobs that aren't balloon-sized. 47. Hatsune Miku Panda Bun figure. The design, simple, but adorable. The colors, pale but alluring, they drag me right in. That panda guy over there, yeah, I like him too. That's the face of basking in this Miku's glory, even if she's being a bit irresponsible with those warm panda buns. Their words, not mine. 46. Kagamine Len, Senbun Sakura. Senbun Sakura got the luxury of full-scale figures and Nendoroids to its name, what a lucky song. But instead of Kaito, Rin and Len accompany the 1/8 scale Miku. And don't get me wrong, they're all amazing. They have super cool flowy physics and stuff, but Len has the least good outfit of the bunch, so he ranks the lowest. But this is nothing new if you know your Len modules. 35. Hatsune Miku, Senbun Sakura. Just look at how those pigtails swoosh, and she's got the best pose with the finger pointing right at us in true Senbun Sakura fashion. But even though I'm pretty sure more love and effort was put into her than Rin and Len. 44. Kagamine Rin, Senbun Sakura. Her outfit's the best, obviously. Just look at that bonnet and the bells in her sandals. I also like how she's given more somber expressions compared to the rest of the Senbun Sakura gang, and this goes for all of them. So I guess Rin's the only one aware of what time period the lyrics describe, or she's just coping with the loss of her right eye, and taking care of the doll is the only way to keep her sanity. It's not here though, so I think she's being forced to go along with Miku and Len until she can hold it again. 43. Miku Hatsune, Love is War version. Oh hell yeah, this is what we need more of. And I'm glad it came from a song as amazing as Love is War, because anything less cool, for that, I don't want to even think about it. So we're getting a little piece of the action, with Miku shouting from the tower she's screaming from with her hair blowing around and a super long wire attached to the megaphone that weirdly ties the whole thing together even more. Of course, it would have been nice if she had more of a tower to stand on, but I'm still glad this exists at all. I could see my dad owning this if he gave the slightest shit about Miku. 42. Hatsune Miku, Love is War Find It version Good Smile Company 20th Anniversary Book. such a special anniversary edition that the colors are more stylized and edgy. But why did they use the original version and not the deluxe one? You'll see why I'm asking this when we get to the deluxe version. 41. Hatsune Miku V4X. In terms of the 3D box art copy-paste figures, very good name for this category, I know. This Miku is definitely the best looking. It's even a little strange just how neat and polished she is, especially with how different the parts of her outfit are. The ends of her boots and sleeve things are a little translucent, the soles on her boots are super metallic and shiny, her skirt's really layered, and what are these underneath her shirt? I don't know, but they make her even cooler. The pigtails don't look like creepy hands either, in fact her whole hair mold looks really nice. 40. Pop-up Parade Hatsune Miku, YYB type version. She's shiny and cybernetic and really cool, and my eyes are so drawn to her that she can't be placed any lower. I wanna show up to a Miku concert wearing this, but I assume this isn't to be confused with YYB's other type of Miku model. 39. Hatsune Miku VN02 Mix. A collab between Max Factory and Nadja Mizzo, best known for the Meltdown PV, and this Miku's based on another one of Iroha's songs, Moon. I assume the coloring from the original video specifically. Either way, I'm glad because we surprisingly don't get a lot of Miku designs with this kind of neon green, let alone officially released 1/8 scale figures. I kinda wish this design could have been used as a Project Diva module, because that's how cool it is, and she's springing into action like a cyberpunk space warrior with two really long sword things resting at her sides. I like to think that either she's escaping some kind of prison and this is the very end of it, or it's some kind of charging station and she's ready to fight again. But no matter what, it's a really cool serious take on Miku that I'd love to see more of. 38. Kagamine Rin. I'm so used to older figures aging like milk that when I see how good this Rin and Len still look, I find it harder to believe that they were made in 2009. It's more of what I like to call simplicity that works. They're just doing poses, but look at how epic they are together. With Rin specifically, I love how her uniform's a lighter color than Len's, as it should be, and her microphone isn't a burnt turd like her Figma's, but... 37. Kagamine Len. He ranks a tiny bit higher because he doesn't need to stick his ass out. He knows he's cool enough to fly off the shelves, and I like how he's playing the guitar. 36. Hatsune Miku, Risa Ebuta version. Risa Ebuta is a popular animator and illustrator, most known for her work on Macross Frontier. And in 2015, Good Smile released this figure based on this artwork she did of Miku, just with a lot more color put into it, thankfully. The sass has also been amplified. I'm pretty sure Miku's boasting that she stole this diamond. I also wish we could see Miku in more classy outfits like these that are still really fun and eye-catching, especially those music sheet tights and the bells on her cape. So even if this hasn't aged the best with how sorta pale, stiff and rough it is, I still appreciate it as another fun and unique take on Miku that gives off some fun badass energy. 35. Pop-up Parade Hatsune Miku, the vampire version L. Yet if any Deco 27 song was getting attention from Good Smile, it'd be this one. It even has an indoroid too now, but until I can properly talk about that, I really dig how the Pop-up Parade figure was done. As much as I love her stylistic art in the PV, I find this misty green hair and other more solid colors a bit more fitting for the song weirdly enough. 34. Hatsune Miku Symphony, 2022 version. I don't know why she needed another figure, nor do I like the eye color or how icky the gold paint is, but it's still the best Symphony Miku design, and having her sit on this ribbon wreath thing makes her a pretty good table decoration. Put her on display at family gatherings and I bet you'll get some compliments for it. 33. Miku Hatsune Append. At last, the Miku Append most based on the box art, and I'm not just saying that because she can't be moved around. It's about the ethereal mysteriousness she gives off, like she's been enlightened into expanding what she's capable of, thus the trend of different voice banks per package that she started. But if I look really closely, she kinda goes from less to more realistic as I go from the cool but sorta funky hair to the feet that are way too human for my liking. It's not the only time I've seen her append self like this either. Weird. 32. Hatsune Miku, Winter Heroine version. Another day, another mobile game crossover, this time from Rage of Bahamut, and I think a lot of these cards would make great scale figure material, but just because Winter Heroine's the only one, doesn't mean it was the wrong choice to make a figure out of. It's so pretty. The outfit's already nice, but with the hair, base, and headphone wire wrapping around her, there's an extra atmospheric feeling going on that I can't get enough of. It looks like she's going ice skating without actual skates and making it work simply because physics don't apply to her virtual body. She belongs right at the Rockefeller Center skating rink, because that's the exact vibe I get from her and always will. But there's still one major problem, and chances are you might have noticed it by now. And the worst part is the winter here in Card doesn't do the same. Come on. 31, Racing Miku, 2015 version. Alright, I'd like to clarify another little something from my first Nindoroid video again. If you watched it and thought making a deal out of her back skirt was a little too weird, I did it because it's layered like a bridal dress cape, thing, whatever it's called. But this is where it looks its best, along with pretty much everything else about her. The hat's amazing, the armor's nice and shiny, and the face doesn't have the same fun attitude as the Nindoroids, but it's also really nice. Also, I didn't notice this about any of her figures, or even a good chunk of the other Racing Mikus until writing this script, but you can spot both the Freeing logo on her boots and the Max Factory one on her gloves, but neither of them worked on this figure lol. 30, Racing Miku 2014 version, the most epic depiction of her original illustration, and I'm not just saying that because of the hair and boot gradients. The 2014 design inherently carries so much of an extra racing edge and attitude, but this whole figure is just brimming with it. So if she already didn't stand out so much from the other Racing Mikus in the best way, here she is with paler colors and sharper details. The panties though? I'm not too surprised about actually. That was bound to happen. 29. Hatsune Miku, vintage dress version. One of my absolute favorite modules from Project Diva has almost been done justice. I absolutely love the pose, crystal microphone, and the little thorny rose prop she's stepping on, but it suffers from the same overly shiny weirdness as most of the other Project Diva figures, and Grizzly Panda isn't credited in her description, but they still specify that she's from Project Diva II even though the module has been around as long as Romeo and Cinderella's been in Project Diva, so you can't fool me good smile, but honestly, I can mostly excuse the distracting shininess because that's how much I love this vintage two-piece dress with a sleeve that's just as disconnected, and lots of ribbons. 28, Kagamine Rin, Rin-chan Now, adult version. That song gives me a migraine, but at least we got a pretty cool idea of what an older Rin would look like. She grew up to be just like Miku, how sweet. Alright, it's just Miku's creepy fantasy about her. Rin needs to call CPS. 27, Pop-Up Parade Hatsune Miku, Future E-Version L-Size. Easily my favorite Pop-Up Parade figure, because they're usually not this unique, so this is a pleasant surprise. And since this is my first chance to properly talk about this magical Mirai Miku, I love how it's a pop-style sci-fi take on Miku mostly in dark pinks and cotton candy blues, and just look at that hair. It might clash a bit with the rest of the figure's softer style, but it actually makes me love it even more. It's like a galaxy starting to form in her pigtails with these stars floating around it. So now she's even more of a certified icon. 26, Hatsune Miku, Love is War version DX. Yeah, it's the same as the first one, but with a bigger stand and more megaphones. Makes you wonder why they weren't there in the first place. 25, Snow Miku. Wait, again? Well, it's Snow Playtime and not the original, and damn it, this is another case of what more Miku figures need to be like. Only she can slide down her own hair like this and make it work because as it spirals from her head, it's like it's hardening into ice. You know I love my dynamic poses, but can we please get more specifically like this? Because I have no more words, this awesomeness is beyond further description. I am not worthy, and neither are you. 24. Hatsune Miku, Miku Expo 5th Anniversary Lucky Orb, UTAX Kasoku version. Even if you've only seen one MMD video in your life, I'm sure you're aware of Miku's Kasoku Shiki model. It's even been in a Frozen Pocky commercial for crying out loud, and this is already a spot-on replica of the model. But to be more specific, it's based on the music video for Emin's song Lucky Orb, made for Miku Expo's 5th Anniversary, a song I don't really like, but everyone involved with the video also had a hand in making her figure absolutely pop off. Literally. Slapping all these graffiti comic style letters all over her clothes wasn't enough, so here they are popping up all around her. Deadpool did it better, but it's still another idea I always love to see in the figure wouldn't stand out as much without them. And this is the only time I've seen a Miku hold her own figure, which is so funny and adorable.
But doesn't she also have-
Shush, don't ruin her for me. 23, Miku Dio, She's beautiful. I know I've ranked her Nindoroids fairly low, but they're not Miku Dayo represented in her truest form, whereas this is the full package. The hair texture alone being the same as the actual costume is amazing enough, but there's also the shiny uniform and expertly painted skin with all their big wrinkles. It's a marvelous homage to who she really is, other than an all-powerful deity whose hilarious presence must be in every crevice of where Miku reaches. Even Project Sekai made two versions of her, and I'm super jealous of the people who got Miku Dayo posters with whatever Miku merch they bought when this came out. If you live outside of Japan too, owning one of these figures will probably be the closest we'll get to seeing Miku Dayo in person, and I think I can accept it. Now if only Mako Dayo and Kaito Dayo could get the same love. In fact, be honest with me, you didn't know they existed until just now, did you? 22, Megarina Iluka, Tony version. Oh yeah, this is how it's done. Take a bit of that realistic edge but leave more than enough room for the usual Vocaloid style. See how hard it isn't to make an amazing figure with just the box art design. But I guess V2 Luka's an immediate guarantee considering how shiny the golden parts of her uniform are. 21, Supercell featuring Miku Hatsune, World is Mine, Natural Frame. This'll sound really weird, but what if I told you that the first Hatsune Miku figure Good Smile Company ever made is still one of their absolute best? Yeah, this is their very first. I still can't believe it either. But also, where better to start than one of Miku's most iconic songs, with an upgraded replica of the original PV art, and you can take her out of the frame too, so it's an extra special standout. But I need to know how she can stay in that frame without falling out when it's hanging like this. I can't find anything about what secures her position, so does anyone know? Is she a magnet, or is this just magic? Doesn't matter, this is still super awesome. 20, Supercell featuring Hatsune Miku, World is Mine, Brown Frame. Still the same extra detailed faithful masterpiece, but 13 years later, they re-release just the brown frame version that goes better with the inside. 19, Racing Miku 2021, Private Version. Wait a minute, is this a good 2021 Racing Miku? No way. All she had to do was get out and travel some more. Sometimes a beautifully casual dress and hat are all I need. But there's also these cool gloves and even cooler 01 choker. And even though I've never left America nor expect to anytime soon, if the chance for a European vacation ever came up somehow, I'd want this Miku to be my travel buddy, or at least use her for pictures. 18, Racing Miku 2017 version. I finally get to talk about my other beloved again, even if it's another default pose and I have nothing new to say about her either besides that, you know that doesn't matter to me, she's still the best Racing Miku. But for the sake of not being a hypocrite, I can't rank her any higher. 17, Snow Miku, Snow Princess version. The only one past the first two lucky enough to get a scale figure, and by God, I completely understand why. How can she and Rabbit Yuki not look their best in absolute 1/7th scale glory? Well, I'm sorry, but the white inner layers of the dress look just a little off. There's too much blue shading for my liking, but the rest of the figure's still awesome. Once again, especially the pigtails, now back to their long luscious glory that the Figma was robbed of. Like my wish for some gold around the crown coming true before I made it in the first place. And if you look really closely at her base, each snowflake bit represents every Snow Miku at the time. I love it. 16, Hatsune Miku, Virtual Pop Star version. Well, okay, another Michi M album cover made into a figure, and wow, is there so much going on. Maybe a bit too much, but I'd rather it all look absolutely stunning than miserably fail at working. And there's been only one other figure so far that's captured just how much Miku has changed the world forever, but this is more on a colorful cosmic level, as it should be. She's hatched out of the Earth sleepy time style, got more planets revolving around her in this giant keyboard ring, and that's a nice guitar. My only gripe is certain parts of the outfit, but otherwise it's also amazing. Is that lace actual lace? I need to know. So yeah, it's one chaotically fun Miku figure, but do I ask for more like it? Or let it be this unique forever? That's the real question. You help me decide in the comments. 15, Kasan Eitato, Yashiro Lament version. It may be Tato's only full-scale figure, but good thing they chose a great song to make any kind of merchandise out of, especially when they top the PV by giving her a full kimono with tons more colors and design patterns all over the top layers. Yeah, no way I need to explain any further, you get the gist. You understand the harmonious discord all over this kimono. By the way, yes, the producers of the original song already remade the song with SynthV Tato, meaning there should be hope for at least one more Tato figure in the future if she's already getting a SynthV Nindoroid. 14, Megarina Luca, Temptation Version. Ooh baby, I'm forever thankful that this exists. Blackjack is already one of my favorite Luca songs with one of my favorite projects Diva PVs, but it made the cut out of countless other modules at the time, so even if a bit of that signature Grizzly Panda gloss is pretty noticeable, especially in her hair, I can let it slide because that's how amazing this design is anyway. She's a sexy casino dealer serving the lookiest of looks in bombastic colors, and I don't feel weird saying that because she's not a minor, and there's an optional face without the little mask thing, but I prefer it with. She's a bit cooler that way. I like the little card prop at the bottom too. Even if this figure still would have been amazing without it, it makes it all the better to me. And check out the bonus bunny ears. What more could you ask for? Cause for me, it's this on display in my house ASAP. 13. Hatsune Miku, Land of the Eternal. Big, fancy traditional Mikus are my gem. So what's not to love about her art from Kyoto Nippon Festival 2019? Okay, maybe that kimono thing's a little too layered, but it's a special night. She's allowed to go crazy, or should I say crazy majestic, because the black layer's leaving a little smoke behind, and I don't care if it's real or just part of the clothes, you make way for this legend. Also, look at those buns with their golden charms and horns with leaves. They go perfectly together. Simply divine. 12. Mikuzukin. I've always loved this module, so obviously I'm gonna adore a physical manifestation of her cuteness that tricks me into thinking the hooded dress and wolf are flocked. But even if they're not, it's still Mikuzukin, so who cares? I want her in my grimy little hands right now. 11. Hatsune Miku, Wedding Dress Version. Come on, you know why it's so high. You're looking at it too. You wish you could have a wedding dress this spectacularly layered and rosy, even if you're never getting married either. And the way her pigtails kinda twist reminds me of the Miku V3 figures, but a bit toned down for formal reasons. And it still works, damn it. Truth be told, even if I never did my other good smile rankings, I still would have looked into how many Vocaloid figures they've done because after first seeing this, I thought how many other phenomenons have they crafted. I had a feeling this would be the best one, even if I'd always ask myself, Miku, you're 16, who are you marrying? Don't tell me it's who I think it is. 10. Hatsune Miku, Harvest Moon Version. Oh wow, Harvest Moon in the top 10. Who could have seen her coming? Well, I've said how the beauty of this very concept is the same between this figure and the Nindoroid, even if I like the Nindoroid's colors and overall softness a bit more, but there's more of this mature, melancholy elegance to the other one, and the hair starting off bluish and fading into a lighter green is awesome, so as long as I somehow get even one Harvest Moon anything, I'll be happy for the rest of my life. 9. Hatsune Miku, Bao Xiao Lu Shui Version. I've touched on her a little bit in my Nindoroid anniversary video, but it obviously wasn't enough. She deserves way more praise as an homage to a Chinese legend, like how if you're not looking close enough, her hair looks like it blends into the water, same with the butterfly, and there's this little ribbon around her that reminds me of Harvest Moon Miku and Ren, and the trees and mountain she's sitting on also look beautiful, and there's a cool flower thing and horns in her hair, and the guzheng instrument the figure was made around. It's all amazingly done. My only real gripe is the outfit's colors. They're not terrible, but the icky green on this sweater clashes hard against her red dress and I can't help but wish it looked a bit more goddessy. Everything else could pass as religious statue material, and that includes the dress's simplicity, but something still feels a little off. Maybe it is just the sweater paint. 8. Luo Tianyi, Gray Nanir Version. Hello again, my other beloved. It seems that I've treated you too harshly in the past. Because yes, your dress is predictably skimpy in a few areas, but it isn't as bad as some of what we've seen before, and you're decorated with some cute charms and surrounded by many more. So melodrama aside, it's still Luo Tianyi being her cute majestic self, and we may be in the top 10, but you'll see more of her soon. 7. Hatsune Miku, 15th Anniversary Version. Another figure I've always loved, but is best when it's bigger. Do you see these pigtails, man? They're bigger than my hair's ever been and that's saying something. And the dress is even wilder. How do you make something this layered but visually harmonic? See this lower white part, Snow Princess? This is what you could have been if you toned your dress down. Oh, and the high heels have their own strawberry seeds on them. As if I didn't already love the fruit now more than ever. This is the absolute best version of 15th Anniversary Miku, and it's a shame this design will never be relevant again after last year. But I also guess it's a good thing that Project Diva and even Sekai didn't add this as a module. Can you imagine how impossible it'd be to program? 6. Luo Tian Yi, Chant of Life version. Gee, we've sure had a lot of fantastical Chinese figures so far, but even with a smaller terrain surrounding her, Tian Yi can't stop owning it in all her works of art. The outfit and flying hair are of course pretty nice, but what's the deal with these antlers? I love them, but even more so, I love everything around her. The crystal tree, the goldfish spirits, Tian Dian growing out of the ground by these mushrooms. Oh, and here's this lantern. Top it all off with some butterflies and you get something about secret forests of the East. So another divine result. 5. Hatsune Miku, Rose Cage version. This is a Project Sekai costume, but it's not for any of the specific groups. Any of the girls and Mizuki can wear it, but no one rocks it quite like Miku. And even though it's already awesome and sparkly, her leaning on a chair with this matching base makes it even more memorable to me. Maybe I just think this whole figure would make a good album or magazine cover. So if there's any outfit in this video I'd want to own, I'm picking this one. I can only hope to be half as pretty as Miku, but it'd be worth a shot. 4. Bbox V singer Luo Tianyi, 10th anniversary Shy Guang version. She's already been out for that long? God, time is merciless and unkind. Friggin' spectacular anniversary figure though, obviously. A celebration true to what makes Tianyi. Tianyi, the sparkle pins, the flowing music notes, the bows and especially this thing. It looks like a Sailor Moon brooch. I love it. Undoubtedly the best in an already fantastic trio of Luo Tianyi figures. But can someone please tell me what's going on with Tian Dian's face? 3. Racing Miku, Tony Haraji version. Yes, I love my figures with super detailed sets. But consider this, I love 2017 Racing Miku. And I love pink kimonos and cherry blossoms. So put them together and thank you Tony. As awesome as it'd be if they made a figure out of her pose with the giant flowers, that wouldn't change her placement. The design's still divine, so much that she has to kneel down to our mortal level. But can she summon more Haruji Racing Miku figures into existence, because they are all so good. You know what, whether or not she can, it's still amazing that she got one. 2. Hatsune Miku, Memorial Dress version. Damn, her 10th anniversary was already pretty big, but why wasn't this the main art used if they made a contest for the thing? And can you believe I had no idea it existed until double-checking before typing the script? But this is the winning contest entry, brought to us by Pomu, and I get a lot of the same vibes here as Ida from Virtual Pop Star, but less cluttered and more fancy, topped off with a rainbow ribbon from the other 10th anniversary Miku, of course. Even though it's another one where I think the awesomeness speaks for itself, the mismatched shoes and sleeves, the flowery microphone, and whatever these things are doing in her hair too good to not point out. I just love her so much and wish she'd be given more attention. That's all I ask, along with all my other questions in the video, but now the time has finally come for the number one spot. And it's Hatsune Miku Symphony, 5th anniversary version. Come on, you've seen my first Nendoroid video. She still is that perfect though, a word I still don't use lately, but if you take an already perfect mix of Miku and a gramophone, make her a music box doll, and put in an actual music box that plays Butai, you get Miku in her most heart-touching form. And there's two heads. Japan keeps winning with their figure brands. She doesn't need to be too flashy, extra colorful, or anything else you'd otherwise expect me to look for. I just need it to look astonishing, to really take my breath away and wish I was rich and worthy enough to own such a luxury. And the bigger and fancier, the better, obviously. I don't even mind how much is teased underneath because it's not like she doesn't wear anything underneath at all, which I'm sure is also true for all the other Mikus that did. But they're not gramophone ballerinas, so I don't care. She's still the ideal depiction of Rella's best Miku design, maybe even the best Miku's ever had. Thus making it my number one favorite Miku scale figure not just from Good Smile, but of all time. A statement that hopefully won't bite me in the ass if I look through her figures from other companies. And or when beauty looking back gets one too. Thanks commenter on my anniversary video, can't wait for how long it'll take for this video to immediately become dated. It's happened before, so it's nothing another anniversary video in July can't fix, or whenever I decide to date because as frustrating as these videos can be to make sometimes, they're always fun to do, and I'm glad a lot of you people watching like them too. So whenever the next ranking in this little series of mine will be, thank you so much for watching my longest one yet, and hopefully my longest one forever. I need to go to bed. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.